What's up, everybody? This is my 2024 season setup. We have my 2024 Ski-Doo Freeride 146 Turbo R, and we have my 2022 Polaris Boost 155 Chaos, and then we have my 2017 Dodge Cummins behind me with the bulletproof 7-foot sled deck on it, and then we have my trailer that I'll be staying in this winter. So I'll go over everything and all the details about my sled builds. First things first, the wraps on these sleds are both the same. I tried to match them up this year, just a little bit different colors. The wrap name is Sight from Poir Wraps in Pemberton, BC. So they hooked me up with wraps on both these sleds. Last year I ran this sled and didn't have any issues with the wrap falling off or any of that. So the wraps do hold up. Next up is Backwoods BMP. We have both the fronts and the rear bumpers along with the Highmark spindles on both sleds, fully kitted out with Backwoods on all my sleds this year, keeping me safe just in case I run into a couple trees. So thank you, Backwoods, for all those parts. Next up is the handlebars. Both sleds have CFR handlebars. This sled, I am running a 2.5-inch Nux riser with the Caleb Kosterke bar and the all black large bar pad along with the CFR signature grips. And on this sled, I am running a 3-inch Nux riser with the Munster signature bar along with the signature grips on this sled as well. And I have the Munster finger throttle with the guard on my Polaris. I'm also putting that on the Ski-Doo when I get to Revelstoke. Full CFR bar setups on both sleds. Definitely like having a consistent bar setup. Switching back and forth is going to be super helpful. This one does have the narrow diameter grips, so I guess I'm going to see which ones I like better, if I like the narrow diameter or the regular, running the Munster and the Kosterke bar. Next thing that I'm running on both sleds is Rock Speed FX tunnel grips. I have the Versa grip. That is the stick-on version that Rock Speed FX offers for tunnel grips. It is a little bit shorter nubs on it, but it is super easy to install and looks really good on the sled. And then on this sled over here, I have the rivet-on version of Rock Speed FX tunnel grips. They have the bigger nubs on them. It's just going to be more grippy. This sled's going to be rowdier, of course, because it is a 146 turbo, so I figured I would put the most grippy version on this sled. And then this thing, I ran it last year without tunnel grips, and my feet did slide off quite a bit, so that should help a lot. I'm also running GGB on both my sleds this year. We're running the GGB mountain can on this sled, and on my 2024 Ski-Doo, I'm running the GGB trail can on that one. So both sleds are going to sound super sick. I'm definitely going to be a little bit louder, but I do like my sleds a little bit louder, so thank you, GGB. A little bit more in-depth on this sled is I have the Ice Age rails, bomber rails. Because when I bought it, it was a 165. So I did the Ice Age Chaos rails, and then I put a M770 from Composite track underneath of it. 3-inch track, so it really chews and hooks up really good. So that is a huge bonus with this sled, is that track really does good in the deep snow. I also have the Backwoods subframes on this sled as well. I opted to go with a Seatco seat cover just because the sled came with a red one, so I went with black and yellow. I also bought these link brackets that raise this up so that you can run the jerry can and your link bag. I could run my 11 liter jerry can along with this deep snow tunnel bag on here. The track setup on this is a 146 with the 2.5-inch track. That's all stock. I'm gonna run it and see if I like it first before I change anything, but I think I'm gonna enjoy it. So that was a quick rundown on my sleds for this 2024 season. Hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you out on the snow.